Hello and welcome to another episode of Thoughtful Leaders by College Dunya. And today we have Dr. Indra Gupta, ma'am, who's the Dean at Rishiraj Dental College, Bhopal. So welcome to College Dunya, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Nishtha.
Ma'am, our viewers would like to get a brief introduction about yourself.
Nishtha, I am at the moment Dean of Rishiraj Dental College, Bhopal. I have served a series of institutions right from government to Gujarat. So I worked at Jamnagar, I worked at Ahmedabad. Then since I have come to Madhya Pradesh after marriage, I have served various institutions like the Modern Dental College, the People's Dental College, Mansarovar Dental College, and I'm back to Rishiraj Dental College as a dean. Apart from this, I have a private practice. So clinics and academics both go hand in hand.
Okay. Ma'am, you have held key positions at various educational institutes throughout your educational career. So what are some of the key factors that keep you connected to the education sector?
It's been 23 years since I've been shaping the future of these dental professionals, maybe as a teacher or as a clinician. And now it is as a principal or dean of a college. To start with, I would say that change is the first thing that keeps me attached to this work profile. The change I have seen is it's in leaps and bounds. And this change that happening in our profession, it keeps you, it keeps on pushing you and keeps you, boosts you up. So I like to be abreast with this thing and staying amongst this younger generation. One needs to update yourself so much, and I like to be one of them. And these young packets of energies keep you charged and they keep you on your tiptoes, and they are in so much great spirits. And I try to be an open-minded person, because that's not always that we are teaching them, but things often go otherwise around also, and it's fun. And I always feel we are those privileged ones who have got good family, good education, and good health. And we have received a lot from the society. I feel it's time to give back to the society. So hence, being a teacher or a dean of a college keeps you, helps you in doing the one. So that's why I like to be a part of the institution.
Ma'am, being the dean at Rishiraj Dental College, what is your philosophy of leadership? And according to you, what is your leadership style?
To be honest, I believe in combination of pace setting and a bit of coaching, both the styles. Pace setting helps me keep the ball rolling and keeps everyone charged for result orientation goals. While coaching style helps me treat people as a pool of talent to be developed. Keeping this in mind, I like to be flexible as in my approach towards leading the staff and students in such a way that they should feel motivated. Along with, also I have stayed in hostels as a student and stayed away from home a lot many times, working in hospitals as well as institutions. So I know the problems that the students face, and this brings me closer to them. Also, I know where they go wrong, where they make excuses, and where they are wrong. So reading in between the lines is very easy for me. Leadership, being a principal is a surreal experience for most of them, but I have to step out of my comfort zone. I know I'll be watched all the time. As a leader, I like to divide roles. I give them the flexibility to perform, guide them whenever required, teach them to make mistakes and own them, but support them on a larger front. So regular de-weeding of useless thoughts that can impair the growth of an institution is a must. I am very grateful to a transparent and approachable management which has built this trust in me. I stand here to serve students and the profession. I know with privilege comes a responsibility. And as a responsible person, and leaders have to be responsible about whatever they do.
Ma'am, being the dean of Dental College, how do you strategize the marketing and administration plans for the institute?
It's certainly not an easy task to manage things at a level with equal standing as well as attention. I always try to do stratification of programs and marketing strategies on basis of priority and create a blueprint before getting onto the floor. Along with this, delegation of work and good team makes things really easy. One should try to preempt the possible opportunities to market yourself and possible stages to put up your best foot forward, showing that we can and that we are engaged in a society in one form or the other, and we are vigilant about things. This all helps us a lot in marketing our own institution.
Ma'am, the education system is structured very differently in India and in foreign countries. So according to you, what can an inbound student gain by studying at your institute?
Yeah, the education system according to the needs of the particular country. In my view, our manager in the college try to benefit students in a way like a caterpillar turning into a beautiful butterfly. Students inbound in our college may expect to become a seasoned professional, well-versed in both vocational as well as real-life scenarios. Our curriculum, which is in sync with the Dental Council of India and the Madhya Pradesh Medical University, is well-prepared to train future dentists and update regularly, and are inclusive of modern-day practices too, in the form of continuing dental education programs from masters in respective fields across the world. Clinical research helps make younger, inquisitive minds to foray into newer horizons of medical science. Whereas various social and public-oriented activities we do a lot, interactions make them empathize with the population they are planning to cater in future.
Okay. Ma'am, being the dean, what are your roles and responsibilities towards the institute?
Once again, I repeat, I feel we are the privileged ones. God has bestowed upon us good family, good education, good health, and a very good approach towards life. I always feel one should give back to the society what we have received and whenever we can. My responsibility is to create a safe and coherent inhabited environment for the students to learn and achieve the best in the times that they spend on our campus and be a wonderful professional in life. It should be equal opportunity to flourish irrespective of the place they come from, the economic strata they come from, they belong to, the religion, the caste they belong to. Everything comes on the common platform and they grow together as a whole. And the stage, and already the stage I want to be on our Rishra Dental College. To the college, I have a bucket list of goals to achieve, out of which I am already on the war path. Turning offline to online, making the campus paperless, reduce landfill, increase overall efficiency, go green and healthy is a new norm. As we all say, hum fit to India hit. That's the motto.
Ma'am, according to you, what are the institute's top priorities over the upcoming 10 years?
We belong to the humongous LNCT group, which is the biggest group of institutions in Central India. It has proven itself time and again for the best in the field and have a reputation of pioneer in the field of education. So, Vishiraj is being a part of this, it is a part of this LNCT group. So we started in 2006 as an undergraduate college, and we started our post-graduation in 2013. So we already have a recognized BDS and MDS degree, and our students every year are holding meritorious positions in the university as well as in the country. Talking about infrastructure requirements, we have been updating ourselves every year to be in the contemporary and state of the art, both the ways. College is currently under seat expansion also. We have applied for expansion in post-graduation in most of the departments also. I foresee the college to be the most sought after dental college in Central India, which should be at pinnacle of clinical practice, academics and research. We should be able to create a central dogma excellence in the field. We would like to expand the college intake capacity, inducting PhD programs, and probably as the borders are diminishing, a global exchange center of students to come to us to learn nuances, and sending our students who for various trainings by tying up with foreign universities. We also would like to start fellowship programs in various specialties and an incubation center for budding dentists. Overall, our goals are aligned to be the best, and our esteemed management is firmly adamant to do so.
Ma'am, when you first joined Shiraj Dental College, what was your vision for the institute and how far you have came implementing that?
Lots of visions, Nishtha. I wanted, again, to make this a place where it is really student-friendly. And the faculty and the students both feel very comfortable working here. They don't work here as if they are working in an institution. It should be a part of their daily life. Updating themselves, keeping themselves abreast of the knowledge should be always in their mind. So, and I have tried always giving flexibility to all the staff and this thing. And this has helped me a lot. Whatever was my vision to make this an institution, not as a working area, but as an area where they can implement whatever they had goals in mind. And I have seen over the last 2 years, things have worked out.
Okay. Ma'am, anything that they might not know about it?
The institution as such? We all know that Rishiraj is a dental college and it started since the year 2006. We even started our post-graduation in 2013. Ours is a college with 100 seats which are recognized both by the Barkatullah University as well as with the MPMSU. We have well-trained and qualified full-time faculty. The infrastructure boasts of a very good college, the quarters, the classrooms, the clinics and the hostels are also very well done. Latest equipments and technologies are strength. We have a load of very good clinical materials. Even in this COVID times, the number of patients of the footfall is really good. Material supply to students and staff is always regular and of a very good quality. Methods of teaching and treating is of latest technique. Continuous upgradation of techniques as well as training of students and staff is always going on. Continuing dental education, research, conferences are an integral part of our daily routine. Curriculum is always followed. The curriculum followed is as per the medical university as well as DCI guidelines.
Ma'am, what are some of the biggest challenges you see for higher education in general and for Rishiraj Dental College?
Better understanding on advancements and embracing newer technologies has resulted in errorless diagnosis of problems, right plans, and simple methods of education, resulting in a predictable outcome. As I said, the field of education is constantly challenging. The biggest challenge is to stay relevant and the state of art as well as flexible to cater the needs of the society and the students. We need to understand that the upcoming generation has been brought up in a very different style. They belong to the digitally global world and at a very fast pace. We can't rely on the traditional methods of teaching. We need to get our socks pulled up to acclimatize the education format accordingly so it suits currently and be futuristic in approach as well. Maintaining the ethics of privatization is also a great challenge.
Ma'am, any suggestion to current youth and aspiring students?
My only advice to aspiring students who want to take up dentistry as a profession or who have already opted this profession, I always keep that to have faith. They need to be very diligent in whatever they do. It takes a lot of grit and hard work to become a doctor. And there is a very fine line between a doctor and a very good doctor. We will make sure that you always stand on the other side of the fence. We will make sure that you stand on the other side because it is your hard work, diligence, availability, and commitment that plays a bigger role. Thus, there is a very limited space on the top. And there is no shortcut to that top. Right? So it's not that it's not you who choose the medicine, but the other way around. They try proving worthy of it. you've chosen this profession, take it seriously and work hard and reach where you are supposed to.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am, for taking out your valuable time and sharing your views with us.
Thank you, Nishtha.